Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Geek Productive YouTube channel if you're brand new, and if you are a regular, welcome back. So guys, today's video is going to be dedicated to an application that is just been released. It's called Method. I was very lucky to be a part of the beta testing for this one. I wanted to share a few of my opinions and thoughts because I was actually impressed with the simplicity and the approach of this application. It's quite a healthy approach, I think, and it's something that a lot of you guys might be interested in. This application is being released on Product Hunt first, and it's going to be rolling out. It's currently only available on web, but the team, Dave, is part of the Buffer team, which is pretty amazing. It's a little bit of a side project for him. So I'm really excited to be checking this one out. It's going to be just a brief overview of it, but it will give you a good idea of how the application works. So as you can see here, this is the web version. I'm using Google Chrome. I'm just going to pin this tab here. As you can see on the left-hand panel, we have something called Backlog. Now, Backlog essentially is for you to add all of your tasks to. So let's add a few of them for the day. Maybe it's Finish, Evernote Alternatives, article. That's one thing I need to do. And what you can do straight away is start adding some subtasks. So I'm going to add a few subtasks. Finish the list, and then finalize the article design. And just below it, if I wanted to, I could very simply add in any notes that I wanted to. And once I hit save, as you can see, it appears in this backlog section. Now let's add a few more tasks and then jump back into this. Okay, so here we are. I've added a few items on this left-hand backlog. And as you can see in front of you, you have today. So it's broken into three core sections, really. You have backlog on that left-hand side, you have today, and you have this calendar function, which essentially pulls in your Google Calendar. At the moment, I believe it's only Google Calendar that you can connect with, and you can even refresh it to up in this top right-hand corner. Now, the great thing is, once you've got this calendar working, it will import some of your current calendar events, which makes it really simplistic. You can go over to this next day, for example, Friday, I have driving lesson and have badminton with Dan. So I can see all of those good stuff there. And as you can imagine, that's very helpful. Now the magic is essentially, comes in when you bring items in from your backlog. So I actually do need to drag this one in to finish today. And as you can see here, it's been given a today item. So it's tickable inside of here. You can, if you want to, move it back to backlog at any given point. But if you want to drag any tasks in, you can do that. If I want to click in and edit any of the checklist items or notes, I can do that there. Now, the awesome thing is if I want to really go in some detail, I can drag it over to this calendar here on this right-hand side, and I can actually change the time amounts. So I'm easily able to calendar block, and I can remove that if I want, move it to another time, or actively move it up and down whilst I'm on it, increasing the length or shortening the time. I can easily calendar block using my tasks. And quite easily as well, I could tick them off and get them done, and they appear on your calendar like this, which is very, very nice. Now, at any given point, I can go to view completed tasks and see an outline of what exactly I completed. Now, let's add a few to the next couple of days. So the great thing is you can have all of these items appear here, and in this backlog, you'll be able to see that this item appears here. So tomorrow I need to pick up tickets from the station, although I haven't actually set a direct time for it. If I go to the next day, you can see that I've planned in a time here of planned bath trip and finalized contract client as some items there. So I've almost essentially calendar blocked it. Moving down, I can also do this per day, and I can even move it back to backlog. And if I wanted to, I could dual add these. So for example, if I had some regular items that I wanted to routinely add in, like finalized contract, I don't know why I'm doing this on the weekend, you can add it into the central today column or what it would be today. So it's a great way to plan ahead and coordinate your activities. Now, at any given point, if I wanted to remove the backlog and be able to see it from this lovely view here, you can do so. And skipping ahead is quite easy, although you can always go back to today using the tab today tab. So guys, this is really simplistic. Method tries to essentially get you to focus on what's important. Over here on this left-hand panel, of course, you have the ability to add tons of new items to your backlog. But again, it's important that you don't add too many because this will fill up fast and you'll be able to add that there. So it's important with this application to be clear and focused on your workload. And I quite like the balance between simplistic application in terms of having your to-dos in front of you for today, combined with the calendar blocking. So that's something that looks really great. There are some applications that are alternatives to these, for example, GetPlan, but what I quite like, and I think the unique approach to this application is the simplicity and the basicness of it. So guys, let me know what you think in the comments below. I will be posting this review very soon. If you're a brand new, if you're a brand new viewer to this channel and you want to subscribe, feel free to subscribe to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. We do regular videos like this on apps and tools and resources, as well as tutorials for you to go a bit further. Anyway, guys, huge thanks for stopping by today. Really hope you enjoyed this one, and I will catch you in a future video. Cheers.